Walk around any university campus and you're likely to see multiple students with various tattoos and piercings. Many people have focused their entire lives into transforming their bodies into works of art.
Body modification would be a conscious decision to change your body from what you were born in to what you really wanted to look like. And we go that could start at changing your hair color, painting your nails, cutting off an appendage, or a digit on an appendage, filling out your teeth, splitting your tongue, completely like cutting open your genitals, removing your your genitals completely. I mean, there's so many things that people do in order to just get closer to what they feel they would be comfortable looking like.
I think it's a form of expression. It's also perhaps to be slightly different, and I find it extremely enjoyable. And I'm a bit of an exhibitionist, or a lot of an exhibitionist, and I enjoy showing the modifications I've had done.
I've had scarification done, because that is, I think, my favorite thing. My favorite would be skin peeling or removal of skin, where we'd actually cut little sections out and take those little chunks of skin out. Other than that, I've got quite a few tattoos, not nearly as many as what I'm aiming to have. Stretch my ears, pierce my tongue. I've done so many piercings. A lot of them I just take out because they damage bits of me and that irritates me. So, yeah.
Piercing wise, I've 208 plus 3 today. On my genitals, my chest, as you can see, neck, my arm, and on my toes. And then other modifications, tattoos all over, full back, butt, legs. Both short sleeves. What we call a short sleeve is the type of shirt I'm wearing, and it hides it. That's the modifications I have done.
I'd say the most extreme would be a customer came in who had pierced a few times, and he asked me to split his tongue. Now, why I'd say that was the most extreme thing for me was because obviously I'd done a little bit of research, and I knew the ins and outs and what to do and what I'm supposed to do, but I'd never done it before, so it was a little bit challenging keeping him calm and myself calm in the sea of blood. But no, it went well, and he was a very good recipient of the procedure. For myself, I would never do anything that would limit my movement. You know what I mean? Whatever I do, it needs to be practical. Like personally, I would never remove any of my digits or appendages or, yeah, they're many things I wouldn't do that would also things that would ruin my gums, things like that, you know what I mean? As far as professionally and doing to somebody else, I think I would limit myself to saying that I would only do something if I can see somebody really commits to the idea. Because a lot of times people want these really obscure things done. Like I've often had people coming in, oh, I want to split my tongue, and they're 17 years old or 18 years old, and you know they haven't thought it through, and they might regret it at a later stage. Not saying they will, but sometimes I think it's just, this is interesting, and now let's try this. And as far as professionally, I wouldn't do something that somebody doesn't seem committed to. Obviously, like, at this stage in South Africa, it's not that, like, far advanced, you know? Like, I'm not saying we're at the, like, foreground of everything, but we do, I think, get exposed to the most amount of people looking to get modified in different ways. So it's a very slow process, and we're just really at the beginning. But I think things will progress quite quickly from here, where we might get more people wanting to get cut and branded and burned and made pretty.